All right, what is going on, lovely ladies and gentlemen? We're here with some more Blaze Blue. I feel bad for numerous reasons, for every reason I deserve to. No, I'm kidding. I feel bad, number one, because almost every single time I've come here, because I've been trying to play at least every single day, just so, you know, my execution doesn't go to shit. I keep the experience of what I'm doing. You know, nothing really, everything stays fresh and I continue to improve rather than like, oh, I didn't play enough. Now I'm losing, you know, what I just did for the last 2 days or whatever. So I've been trying to play every single day, but I have really just not been having those, you know, sleeping problems that I have periodically. I haven't really been able to sleep, so I've just been too tired to, like, want to record, want to commentate. Because there are some games where, like, being tired and loopy, it works out for recording them. Fighting games is not one of them. Everything about fighting games when you're tired gets aggravating. So, I haven't been recording, but, like, every single time, at least one person has come up and been like, "Hi, Nate, good game." Like, they know who I am, and I feel bad because, like, I'm not recording, so I don't know if they're expecting that their matches got recorded. But I'm sorry if you saw me. Basically, since the last video, I wasn't recording. Sorry. But one thing I do want to mention, Rizuku, my brother, my homie, you came up when I was playing Mr. Blaze Guy. Mr. Blaze Guy, being the polite gentleman he is, asked, like, "Yo, dude, do you want to play Nate?" Like, he recognized me. He said, "Hey, what's going on?" And so Mr. Blaze Guy said, "You want to play?" And Rizuku said, "No, I only have a one-bar connection." As you can see, this is perfect. This dude has a one-bar connection, too. I'm perfectly willing to play anything. 100% fine with at least trying it out. Because very often, there are zero-bar connections that are absolute shit. I mean, there are zero-bar connections that are fine and three-bar connections that are absolute shit. So, like, it's not a guarantee that a zero or a one bar connection is going to be bad. It could be good, so I'm always willing to at least try once, and then if it is too laggy, if it's like, alright, that's not even worth playing in, so be it, that's how it'll be. But at least we gave it a shot and we know for sure, right? So never be afraid to come and try and play me. Unless I'm having a really bad day, I won't say no to a bad connect, to a potentially bad connection. Did he really? Speaking of bad connections, this one's not great. Fuck you. Fuck you. Oh. Okay. Wants to do run up forward? That's 4D, right? Oh my god. Oh, is that not punishable? I guess that's not punishable. Fuck you. Why was that not a counter hit? Fuck you. That was a counter hit! Yeah, there's some 4D. That's just... Oh my god, I suck. Yo, this Noelle gameplay, though? We got some input lag going on right now. And it's making me sad. Oh, I am a dick. A massive, beautiful dick. Oops, that was all wrong. Oh, there, now you can see the lag. See, I'm not lying. I don't lie. I'm gonna do 2C. Oh, he wanted to die. He wanted to accept the death. I don't blame you. Noelle against Tager's bad enough. Then we gotta fight in lag. It's not, I don't blame you for wanting to kill yourself. But yeah, so let me just say, straight up, firstly, if you come up to me and we do want to play and you end up using Kagura or Jin, I am going to be the most vitriolic asshole you have ever heard or seen in your life. Here's a perfect example. I am just so sick of those characters. I have played, like, nothing, because the aforementioned Mr. Blaze guy, Spirits Rise, two people that I know and I have played previously, both use Kagura, but I have run into just an unfair amount of Jin and Kagura. Like, aside from those two, I've still, and every single Jin uses this fucking color. Every single one. And now this asshole is skipping the intro. Don't skip the fucking intro. I'm gonna go in because he skipped the intro. I'm gonna get hit by that. He could have confirmed that. Really? He's coming in mashing JA? This is how this dude plays. No wonder you're a blue square. good God, this lag. Good God. Like, did you see how slow that throw was? And it still worked. Oh my God. I'm sorry, why didn't that hit? Like, real talk, why didn't that fucking hit? This dude's having no troubles with his combos whatsoever either. Like, this dude lives in this. Nailed it. God fucking damn it. I'm sorry? I'm fucking sorry? I'm sorry? Yo, everything that just happened there was bullshit. Wow. Wow. Fucking help me. Like, somebody please. SOS. Fucking SOS so bad. Oh my God. Oh my God. This is how this dude plays. This is how this dude fucking plays. Wow. Oh my God. Oh my God. This is what I get. This is, what did I do? What did I do to the universe to deserve this? Not only a Jin, but a Jin in this. What have I done to the world? Good golly G Willikers on a biscuit with fucking gravy, which by the way is one of the new flavors that Frito-Lay rolled out. Why? Like, that's just for a chip? These overheads though? Like, can we talk about my overhead game being just absolutely fucking godlike? Can we talk about my anti-air game just being fucking godlike? Like, dude, I'm so good. I am so good. I am so good. You have no idea. Like, I just showed just perfect footsies, absolutely optimal neutral game. Like, you have never seen a better Tager performance than you just saw right there. Who's Grandia? I don't fucking know, but he's an irrelevant dude now. Nate taking over. Let me get a sip of my drink. It's just water. It's boring. It's actually really weird. I used to, for whatever reason, I guess maybe it's because I'm a dumbass. I'd assume that's what it is. I used to never really drink water. Like, for a while, I basically, like, orange juice. So, I mean, honestly, anything that was not water, I drank it. Now, like, all I really drink is water. I don't know if it's just a feature of, like, I've grown up. I don't know what it is, or just the understanding that I was probably walking around half the time dehydrated as fuck. Because I actually used to have a, what the hell is that shit, that medicine, Accutane, right? That's the medicine that you use for, particularly bad, acne? I had particularly bad acne when I was a child, and so I had to take that shit, and that stuff just, one of the main things they tell you is like, dude, your lips are going to be dry as hell. Carry something around, you know, chapstick, whatever. And ever since I took that, like, I've gotten really easily chapped lips. And so I used to just always walk around like I just had chapped lips, which is wonderfully appealing to all of the females in the world that met me. You know, like, oh yes, let me make out with this dude with chapped lips. It just, so my panties are dropped like right away every single time I met a female. That was how it went down, guaranteed. I wouldn't lie about that. But so, ever since, like, I've started drinking water. Now, this is ages ago, but still, like, oh, no. Oh, shit, I think I played this dude before, and it was awful. But, yeah, I've always started drinking, like, a ton of water now, and ever since then, oh, no, don't you fuck. Oh, that's even worse. Oh, no. But, yeah, I'm pretty sure I've played this dude before. No, never mind, I've not played this dude. Maybe I have. I do remember the icon. But I think I would remember playing a 400 plus game Azreal, especially if the lag was pretty bad. But you can always tell, like, oh no, another, why can't people just be fucking patient? This game is built around letting the intro play. Yo, this dude is using simple mode? I mashed buttons. That was a bad button to mash. Really? Yeah, this dude's using simple mode Asriel. Yo, that was like just so amazing of a combo. Useless ass fucking D moves. Why didn't my A's keep coming out? That's not gonna kill me though. But still, why didn't my A buttons keep coming out? Oh my. Oh. Okay. All right. I'm playing simple mode Asriel. So let me turn my brain off, because I know what I'm fighting now. Oh my god. I don't know what I'm fighting now. I'm not prepared for this. What? Why didn't my button did not come out at all, but I still got countered? Like, my button just will not come out right now. There, it came out right there. There's really nothing I can do about Asriel's backdash. Like, not when he's unmagnetized. Nice insta block, Nate. Why did that button just come out? Like, I completely deserve that, but that button should not have come out. Alright, okay. I know who I'm playing now. Let's do this. It's my own fault. Like, I'm trying to play footsies against somebody that has no interest in doing so. So, like, let me let him be stupid, and I will beat him while he is stupid. Like, let me just... I actually want to work on this, because you see him doing nothing but, I mean, I'm sure he's probably going to leave after this, because that's usually what players like this do. But let me try to get used to trying to 360A this guy's Gustavs on reaction. Because that's all he's doing in neutral, right? He's just mashing on backdash and then doing Gustav. I can... Tager can 360A that on reaction. I can beat that clean. So, like, there's no issue trying to do that. I was trying to play footsies with somebody who is just not going to do... Oh, that's right. Stylish. That's what it's called. That's what they changed it to. It used to be simple mode, right? But yeah, now that I know what I'm dealing with, like, the distance he's doing those from is just stupid. Like, I could backdash 360 them, I can just raw 360 them. Every single answer in the world is at my fingertips, but it was just kind of like, you don't expect that kind of stupid, if that makes sense. I cannot that was a 360A right there. That was a four jump, super jump. Okay, he's just mashing it. Alright, if he just mashes it, like, that doesn't work. This dude is mind gaming me out, bro. This dude is godlike! Except he don't let that happen. Like, why would you let that happen? Yeah, I should have known that would work. Bitch. I actually think... Oh, never mind, he's gonna mash. What I wanted to find out there, which now I don't have information on, I wanted to know if that would catch backdash. But see, like, this is what I mean. You just turn your brain off. Oh my god, damn it. Smart. That is how you deal with that. Like, I'm just gonna keep doing that. There's really no reason not to. Fuck, I got the wrong one. God damn, I think they completely removed the invincibility from that. Because something like that used to... That would have worked. That's something that would have worked previously. Real talk? Buttons didn't come out. Burst didn't come out. Gotta love it. Online, everybody! It's gonna make you lose to shitty simple mode Azrioth! Oh wow, that actually punished me. I blocked that. Like, that's 5B. You know how easy it is to block 5B like that? 360A, motherfucker! That was supposed to be a punish. It was not. Fuck you, lag! There's nothing I can do. There's nothing I can fucking do. I tried to armor that and it didn't come out fast enough. Because of lag! I'm dead. Kudos. Kudos. See, but this is what I'm talking about. Like, what do you do in a match like this where... This is simple mode, right? Like, everything he does works. There's nothing you can do about that. All you gotta do is press buttons. Versus me trying to do shit in an unoptimal connection with the person that... But I refuse to continue losing to this. I refuse. I'm gonna beat this. Because the thing is like, everything he's doing is based upon lag. And... is counting on that lag to get the win for him, right? Like, that's why simple mode works, stylish mode works out so well online, is because it can't fuck up. Latency doesn't affect you anymore. It's completely irrelevant. The game is doing everything for you, and the game bypasses that latency. And so, like, now the question is, everything this, like I said, everything this man is doing is dependent upon lag to work. None of this would work in a manner where I could actually react in a, you know, optimal environment. So, this is the perfect player to play against because of the fact that it is so based around lag. I need to learn how to fight this kind of thing if I want to be successful in net play, and I need to stop trying to hit buttons because Gustav is just that good. I can't even fucking get, like, what does it fucking matter? If I can't get my goddamn atomic colliders out. That is the number one cause. Okay, so he's doing that every single time. So I'm going to start too soon after Gustav now. Person's not mashing enough. Really? So that must not be punishable in any way, shape, or form. What? I don't know why that caught me. Not going to kill me. Yeah, there's nothing I can do about it. I'm dead. I'm dead. Foolish of me. I should have just done Magnetech Wheel. There was no reason for me there not to do Magnetech Wheel. But I didn't do it. I'm making dumb decisions. God fucking damn it. My bad. I forgot. 2C. God damn, I do not have the timing necessary to do that. Why do I keep doing that? I know I can't be doing that. Growler. Fucking hell. Fucking hell. Like, of course I'm not gonna beat anybody, stylish mode, masher or not. Of course I'm not gonna fucking win. Oh my god. If I can't fucking complete combos. And this dude has no idea how to mix it up. Thank you. What? So, like, every single reaction he does is based off of, like, the last thing I did. Right? Like, so, if I caught his backdash, like, that last time when I tried to gadget finger and I fucked up the timing by a little bit, like, that does work free. Well, actually, it works free if you do 360B. Because 360A, the grab isn't fast enough to actually grab him before he can backdash again. But that's one of my issues that I need to work through right now, is I don't use 360B, like, at all, ever. And that's something I need to work on, because 360B is a hell of a lot faster. But so how, after I did the try to gadget finger him, which prevents the backdash, like he doesn't go anywhere when he backdashes if I do that gadget finger with. So the very next thing he did, mash. When I started the 360A his Gustav, the very first thing he started to do was jump after Gustav. Everything he does is based off of the assumption that I am going to continue doing the same thing. Which, granted, I've been doing a lot. I continue the 360A after Gustav instead of 2C'ing him like I said I should. Why am I still playing this guy? Like, win or lose, this one, I'm out. Like, I cannot stand people that do not... I should have just left the moment he skipped the intro the first time. God damn it. God damn it. What? Thank you for the 360A instead of the 5A! The 360A would have fucking worked! Wow, that's dumb. Like, why does... I have not a single time so far. I have not thrown Sparkbolt at him a single time from full screen, and he keeps growling. This is this dude. He has no idea what he's doing. Oh, that was my fault. Thank you for the backdash. That was a wonder... That was an absolutely beautiful backdash. My fault, again. Where was the... Okay. I didn't chase it down! God damn, dude! Oh my god. Why is my execution all of a sudden, like, I cannot do the fucking atomic colliders for the life of me. Oh boy. Thanks for the games. Enjoy your stylish mode, Azreal. I mean, I guess it's cool if that's what you're looking for. Like, if you derive pleasure from just trolling people like that, like, kudos. Because obviously he was just trying for Astral every single time against me, which obviously he caught me twice. Kudos to him. Then, what else? The whole backdash spamming thing, which is like, unfortunately, that's actually something that's really strong against Tager. You need really specific timing to beat Azreal's backdash as Tager. To beat Azreal's backdash as anybody, really, you need really specific timing. And I don't have that timing anywhere, let alone online. But, so, yeah, I don't know. It's just not... I just don't really... I can't see any way in which that would be fun. But that's me, right? Like, I don't have the same tastes. I don't have the same... ideas surrounding what I get pleasure from in games and whatnot. So, I don't know. Uh-oh. If Biscuits don't want to play this dude, what's it going to be with me? I don't know what the connection is. Oh, are you actually going to run up against another Tager? I will not do a Tager mirror match. It is absolutely not going to happen. I will go straight to Azreal. Great. I would rather play the Tiger Mirror match. He's gonna troll. Now we have no idea. He's gonna troll around the character select screen for a while. Don't do Kagura. Fuck! Stylish. He's gonna do stylish Kagura. He's gonna do stylish Kagura. Then I'm gonna use Azrael. It would actually. Tiger would actually probably be better against stylish Kagura. Oh, this idiot doesn't even have any experience with it. But yeah, like, the whole point is that there's no charge to his moves, right? Like, you can just do his shit. So you can just throw out a fireball whenever you want. You can just throw out his DP whenever you want. Wow, this is an absolute shit-tier connection. Holy God, I made a mistake. I will probably just end up losing to this dude and not give a damn. Like, I will, if the connection is as bad as it seems, I am just gonna walk into everything he does. Or he's gonna mash on the A button. Down plus D, bruh. Down plus D, bruh. Down plus D, bruh. Down plus D, bruh. I learned how to play Stylish Kagura because I did arcade mode. I've been going through arcade mode and using the stylish characters to get through it. This connection is actually not that bad. Like, it looked like it would be way fucking worse than I thought it would be. I changed my mind. This is terrible. After doing that, after seeing how long it was taking for my dashes to come out in the middle of that, never mind. Never mind. I lied. That's terrible. Please don't come back. Please leave. Because I don't want it. It's the worst thing in the world. You have no idea how aggravating it is to me. Look at this. I see so few actual real connections. Okay, good. Thank you. Thank you for understanding that connection was shit tier and for leaving it. I appreciate it. But yeah, so you have no idea how aggravating it is, because every single time I come out of here, it basically resets the connections. Like, it's not a 100% guarantee that's going to reset all the connections that I see, but like you can see, most of these are listed as 4-bar connections. They're not 4-bar connections. So it is very, very, very rare that I can actually come out of this and see, like, oh, okay, this person's a 2-bar connection, let me try to play them. Or this person's a 3-bar connection, let me try to play them. I almost never see real connections. And it sucks. It makes me so sad. And it's the same thing. I have never once seen an actual ranked match. See, like, this dude just went from 0 to 4. What is this game's problem? God damn, do not buy PS4 versions from Arc System Works. Just don't fucking do it. But yeah, so, I've sat in ranked, like, just with the thing open and just occasionally. So, like, I'm, what do they call it? Reserved for a match or whatever the hell they call it. So I'm sitting there, you know, like, ready for a match so people can challenge me or I can see who's there, to pick for myself. I have never, in the history of this game, seen a connection listed during ranked. Not once. Player matches, almost never. Very, very rarely, like maybe 5% of the rooms that are ever listed, I see a connection for. God, please don't use Jhen. Please don't use Jhen. Oh, what the fuck? I'm fine with it. At this point, I kind of just pull out Azrael for the Morocomos, and other than that, like, I don't care. But it's just Tiger against the Morocomos. It's just like Beast Legend Prey. There's really no trying to fight them in neutral game because they, well, Moo is a little bit, I kind of say that Nu is really the only one I'm talking about there. Nobody plays Lambda and Moo is kind of iffy. Like, she's not that as crazy as Nu is. Quick ass burst, this homie scared of me. Oh, that's cool. Oops. That should have been blocked! Okay, okay, okay. Oops, that's an overhead. Very nice confirm. Very nice confirm. Wow. and 5D not being faster. Oh shit. Wow, that was awesome. I guess it was a good thing that didn't come out. Oh, right. Maybe I should have picked Azrael. I should have picked Azrael. This is a terrible matchup. I should have just picked Azrael. What was I thinking? Why am I trying to play shitty matchups with Tager? Wow. Like, that's not even a move that's usually reserved for anti-airs. That's not what I wanted. God fucking damn it. Bad spacing on my part. Oops. Don't ask me why I stood up. I have no answer. Don't ask me why I just hit a button jumping in on Lychee. I don't have an answer. Wow. He didn't DP. Respect. Where was my fucking... Actually, I don't even know if I'm hitting the right button, to be perfectly honest. That was supposed to be barrier, and I got a button instead. Because that's how good my execution is! Good golly gee willikers. Ooh, like, I'm already playing in a bad matchup, and I can't even get the shit that I want. Like, of course I'm not gonna fucking win here. I didn't think that would work that closely for some reason, like when I was that close to her. Why did the fucking second sledge not come out? H yo! But yeah, it's like, I'm already fighting a pretty bad matchup. But, god fucking damn, dude. Ha! God fucking damn it! That magnet, that would have worked had she not gone into stance, but stance does prevent. Ooh, wow. I was not a 720, which would have worked. My burst didn't come out, so now I'm gonna die. That's something that's actually really weird. I'm not sure why it happens. But so, I mapped a button to hitting all four buttons. Because, like, I can't even barrier half the time when I try to just press down two buttons. Guess how good I am at pressing down all four buttons on the pad. Like, it just doesn't really fucking work a lot of the time. And so, because of that, I just made a button mapped to the pressing all four buttons at once. It works 100% of the time with overdrive. 100% of the time when I try to overdrive, it comes out. If I try to burst, sometimes it just doesn't work. And like, I've actually been burst baited thanks to that. Where like, I'm in the middle of a combo and it's gonna be a kill combo. So a lot of the times people are looking to burst bait you when there's a combo that you know will kill and you have your burst. So a lot of the times people will just drop their combo. But you know, when it's against somebody that I don't wanna risk that potential happening, I will burst at a point that I know is safe. So like a multi-hit move that they can't do anything except a hard call out, like if they rapid cancel in the middle of it, that kind of thing. But sometimes the burst just doesn't come out when I press the thing I have mapped to all four buttons. That was cool. God damn! I was supposed to be two scene. I somehow failed at that. That was good. Wow. Wow, that was all stupid. That didn't even reach? My shit didn't even reach? Are you serious? My fault for mashing buttons here. Are you fucking kidding me? Really, 5D? You're that goddamn awful? God fucking damn! I hate everything about this character right now. Everything, like, everything this Lychee is doing is working. Everything that I do does not. Yeah, I'm dead. Like, this is pissing me off so much. I cannot hit this character because all of her pokes are better than mine. All of her... oh my god, are you fucking kidding me? This actually probably isn't gonna kill her, and that was a bad idea. What the fuck? Yo, magnetism just did nothing. Magnetism did literally nothing there. Are you fucking this character, dude? This is definitely the makings of an A-tier character, right, guys? Everything's working. My neutral is just fucking on point. That was a backdash. What? Why is all of this? Why did all of that just happen? I'm getting so angry. You have no idea how angry I am right now, and it's literally only because, like, shit that should be working is not happening. Seriously? God fucking damn it. Okay, 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 okay. You wanna hold up? He's not gonna hold up next time, though. Guaranteed. I always fucking forget that she can do that. That she can aim it upwards. What the? Great. I don't know why I didn't block that. Don't ask. I know why I didn't block that, because she deserves to have 360A! For fuck's sake! Oh my god. I'm telling, dude, everything with this character works. Nothing that I can do will work. I deserve that. That was bad. That was really bad. Why did they remove the invincibility from that move? Like, seriously, the invincibility is just gone. No joke, invincibility is just gone. I'm hit. That's it. I'm done. I'm done. I'm done playing. I'm done fighting Lychee. I mean, this video's gone on long enough anyway, but I'm done trying to fight Lychee with Tager. Like, because there's the part of me that's like, that part of me that's like, I want to learn this matchup. I want to be able to beat this character with this other character. But Tager has every single disadvantage in that matchup. He has nothing going for him. The only time he actually beats Lychee is when Lychee is staffless. That's the only time, because I can actually do shit to her. But she can option select her DP. She can... her backdash, like that little backdash then flip thing, whatever the hell that is, outranges everything I do. So unless I hard call out 5D against that, which is absurdly unsafe, and if they see that coming out, they can react to it and just punch me in the face and get a full combo, and now I'm on my ass. Anyway, point being, let's just talk about this real quick, right? Tager's A plus tier, right? That's what people consider him, A plus tier. Loses horribly. Loses fairly badly. Loses terribly. Loses terribly. Loses terribly, loses awfully. But this character's A tier, right? Right? When he loses to just a third of the cast straight off. And not even in like, oh, you know, this matchup's 5.5, 4.5. No, it's a pointless fucking matchup. I mean, like, I do have it planned at some point in time. I want to just talk about the game in general and how I feel about Tager, how I feel about the other characters that I use, what is going on in my head throughout all of this. But it just blows my mind that anybody who factors matchups into their tier list would ever put a character like Tager on A tier, who just straight up loses to so much of the cast. The only way that would work is if every single character I just listed was considered an S tier character. So it's like, Tager loses to every single one of these characters. However, Tager then beats every single other character. So it would be perfectly fine if all, you know, 10 of those characters were S tier, and then Tager was at the top of A tier. That would make perfect sense, but that's not how it is. Does anybody in their right mind consider Amane an S tier character? Does anybody consider Lambda an S tier character? Relius, Carl, I think I actually missed Arakuni. Arakuni, Rachel, Kokonoe now, are any of those characters S tier? It's absolutely absurd to me that anybody could think Tager's an A tier character just based upon the fact that he has better combos now. That's not what makes a good fucking character. Irritates the hell out of me. But anyway, so yeah, like, because basically the entire thing that it boils down to that I was going to talk about, this character, right? So the problem with having a Tager and having an Azreal and not really having anything else is that Azreal struggles at the same matchups as Tager does, just to a lower degree, because Azreal, just the very simple fact that Azreal can dash gives him that much more of an advantage in the matchups that Tager struggles with when it comes to catching other players. So obviously Azreal, even though, like I said, he still struggles with the same matchup, Azreal Hazuma is my most hated matchup using this character. Against the Murakumo units, he's not fantastic. There are other characters, like Lychee, I would say is actually fairly even, just for the sole fact that, like, you can annihilate her so easily. It's just, she has every advantage in neutral, but you have every advantage otherwise, so that kind of evens itself out. But yeah, it's just, like, Azreal struggles at the same stuff that Tager struggles at. So, like, having these two characters doesn't help me at all, because I'm not like, oh, I can just pick this character to cover these matchups that I fucking hate. Like, I have never once in my life, doesn't matter who the Lychee player is, doesn't matter how good the Lychee player is, this can also be extended to Nu, Relius or Carl, Hazuma, any of the characters I just listed, doesn't matter how good or bad they are, I have never once enjoyed fighting them, period. Like, not, don't have to throw in, you know, oh, I haven't enjoyed playing them with Tager, I haven't enjoyed playing them with Azreal, I haven't enjoyed playing them with Bullet, I haven't enjoyed playing them with Jhin. I just straight up do not enjoy fighting those characters, period. And so then you add in the fact that Tager is so shit against them to begin with, and it's just like, ugh, why am I even bothering? Because that dude did what he should. 100%, that dude did everything that no other player in America does, no other net play player does. For some reason, people are so adverse to just running away, which works wonders with Tager. And again, this is all stuff that I have planned to talk about, so I don't want to get too in-depth with it. But that dude did what you're supposed to do once you're magnetized by Tager. You don't stick around him. You jump away and you backdash or whatever, and you use, you know, one of the options to get away that you have. Use the one that is the most likely to succeed, and just get away. And once you're out of basically, like, 3/4 of 5C range, you're not in danger anymore. There's nothing to really be scared about. And so you just keep on mashing on backdash, you get full screen, negative penalty never activates, because negative penalty is an absolute shit, worthless mechanic, and you're gone. You're safe. There's nothing Tager can do from full screen. Unless I have Spark Bolt, but what the fuck does it matter? You're already magnetized, so I can't use Spark Bolt to just get magnetism on you. You already have magnetism, and you've shown me how ineffectual it is. So I want to hit with this Spark Bolt. But what the fuck are you going to do pressing buttons at full screen? Nobody intelligent that is actually running away intelligently is going to get hit by Spark Bolt from that range. That, like I said, that dude did it right. He just ran. Because Lychee has every single possible advantage at neutral. Lychee just destroys Tager in every single possible way. There is no range at which Tager is better of a character, has better normals than Lychee. The only time Tager has the advantage is when Lychee is in block stun and cannot use those normals. Other than that, like I said, there's no range whatsoever. Now, this is also coming from, like, this anger, this aggravate. I don't want to call it anger because I'm not really, like, fuming or anything. I'm aggravated. Most of that is stemming from the fact that obviously I can't execute half my fucking combos. You have no idea, unless you experience it yourself, you have shitty execution. You have no idea how much it sucks to finally, especially with a character like Tager, where you're struggling to get a hit, you're spending like 30 seconds just blocking, playing defense, looking for that one little opportunity to finally land a hit, and then you finally do it, and then your dumbass drops the combo and doesn't even take advantage of it. You lose your Oki, you lose the rest of your damage, you lose everything that gives you a chance in this matchup. And so that right there is what absolutely murders me. Not the fact that I'm playing a bad matchup, not the fact that I'm playing against a character that I don't even like in the first place, the fact that when I finally manage to land something, I fuck up the advantage. And that's where most of the anger stems from. And so, like, I mean, obviously, that's just something I have to work on. Like, there's nothing that can be said about it. I am forced to use a pad playing this game. Thus, my execution's going to suck because I will never sit down and grind out execution on pad when every single problem that I have here, I don't have on the controller that I would choose to use had I the choice. And so it's something, you know, that's just some salt that I gotta hold in my chest, right? Like, there's nothing I can do about that. All of it is on me, but it's still just so fucking aggravating. So anyway, after all of that, I'm finally done ranting and raving. Hopefully next time we'll be able to do better. I mean, I don't know, like, I really, like I said, I'm gonna talk about it more, but I really just need to settle for the fact that, like, there are certain characters that I should just pick Azreal against to save myself from heart rate upping. I don't know. Anyway, peace out. Hope y'all have fun. More fun than I just did.